Hi, my name is Alok and I welcome you to this introductory session on low-cost automation. So this is a 6 minutes video module and it is not a full-fledged module. The 6 minutes video module is a precursory or the introductory session for the full-fledged workshop that we are going to conduct in next week. And in this low-cost automation session, I will be sharing about six major things which are critical to understand for low-cost automation. So the things that I'm going to cover one by one is the first thing I'll be covering on how do you define a low-cost automation. And there is another principle called zero-cost automation, which is one step ahead of low-cost automation techniques. So we'll be discussing in detail about the low-cost automation and zero-cost automation. The second thing that I am going to cover is the automation initiative failures. So why the automation initiative failure? If you remember, or you must have observed that almost 50% of the automation initiative that we designed by ourselves fails. And I'll discuss the reason for failure as well as different techniques for sustenance of the automation. The third important point I'll be covering is to enable you to take a decision that do you really require implementing a low-cost automation or not. So whenever our management asks us to do some project on cost reduction, so the first thing that comes to our mind is low-cost automation. So we will see in detail that is your process is suitable for low-cost automation or not. Because if your process is not suitable for low-cost automation and you try to design and implement, then either we'll be wasting a lot of time and money as well as sustenance will be difficult. The fourth thing that I'm going to share during the upcoming session is about conducting cost benefit analysis and return on investment analysis, which is a major concern for management because whenever they want to implement low cost automation, so the major financial constraint is about how to understand there will be some return on investment on that automation and is it financially suitable for implementing this thing or not. The next thing I'll be sharing is on different scientific and structured guideline tools and principles to develop automation. And I'll also share you some of the video examples of innovative low-cost automation and zero-cost automation. So these video examples can be used as a benchmark and you can take some references from this video example and try to correlate with the process. And you can also get some idea to take from these videos and try to implement in your own organization. So these are the six things that I'm going to cover in the upcoming full-fledged video workshop next week. In this video workshop, I'll also cover the LCA approach or low-cost automation approach where what are the different manufacturing level of the processes like level 0 to level 5 and what is the tentative benefit in terms of cost reduction productivity that you will get if you keep on implementing step-by-step automation level. And important parameter that I'll be sharing here is about which level of manufacturing maturity requires which level of automation, what level of automation. For example, if you are from zero level, then how to design low zero cost automation. And if you're in level two, then how to design low cost automation. When you talk about the sustenance of any automation, so this is a critical point because if you are in level zero and you want to implement low cost automation at a level of three, then definitely the sustenance would be a question mark for us. So how to move step by step in terms of implementation of automation is a major part of the sustenance strategy. Besides that, I'll also share some scientific principles and guidelines about how to innovate or how to do the brainstorming by a methodology called Scamper methodology to identify and innovate different possible automations for your process. I'll also share the 10 guidelines for the designing of low-cost automation. And I'll also share the major part on how to sustain, like how do you educate people, how do you envision the project, how do you enable them to design it, how do you engineer the product, and how do you evaluate the successful implementation. So these are some of the things that I'm going to cover in detail in our upcoming video session, video workshop next week, and I look forward to hosting. Thank you.